Hi James, the purpose of this video is to help all those folks who are new to Linux and DFI world and are facing challenges while installing the latest version of Sift Workstation image on Ubuntu. The image which I am going to use was released on May month of 2021. I have also mentioned the steps which I am going to demonstrate in this video in the text format and can be accessed through the link shared in the description section below. So let's get started. First thing first, let's open the SANS webpage. For that, simply search SANS Sift Workstation on Google search. Now click on the first link which will be displaying on your window. Here we can see that there are three options through which we can install and work on the Sift Workstation. First option allows us to download a Sift VM image that is .ova file and which you can use directly as a standalone virtual machine on the VMware or VirtualBox, whichever virtualization application you have on your machine. Second option is the one that we are going to use today. Here we will see how to install the Sift on Ubuntu, which will be running as a VM on a VMware. Third and the final option is for Windows user. Those who don't want to use any virtualization software and want to use Sift on their base machine, they can do so by leveraging the Windows service, which is Windows Subsystem for Linux. This service was introduced in Windows 10. This is by default disabled and need to be enabled manually, which you can do it easily by following this link. I have tried all the three options. Personally, I found second option to be working fine in my case. So let's follow the steps mentioned in the second option. So the first thing is obviously to have Ubuntu installed, and that too the latest version, which is 20.04. Install the Ubuntu image from the ISO file in your virtualization application. For this video, I'm using VMware. If you want to know how to do Ubuntu installation in a VMware, then please follow the link which I have mentioned in the description section below. In my case, Ubuntu is already installed in my machine and I have already started it. Let's open the terminal and quickly check the Ubuntu version just for validation purpose. So the command would be lsp_release-d. So there it is mentioned as Ubuntu 20.04. So the first requirement is fulfilled. We have Ubuntu 20.04 installed and running. Let's follow the next step, which is to download and install Sift CLI. Click on the install instruction link. Go to the latest releases. And download these three files: Sift CLI Linux, Sift CLI Linux.sig, Sift CLI.pub. For that, let's copy the link address and type the wget command on the terminal. Sudo wget and paste the link. So downloading has started, let it complete. Alright, first file is downloaded. For the second file, simply go back to the browser, copy the link of the second file and paste in the terminal. Second one is also downloaded. Similarly, do the same for the third file as well. The third file is also downloaded. Now all the three files should be available in our present working directory, which is local directory. So let's quickly validate it. Yes, we can see the three files are present under the local directory. Now next step is to download the cosign. For that, just go back to the instruction page that we are following. and select the install cosign link. Meanwhile this link is opening, I would like to share this information that cosign is a tool which is developed by Google in collaboration with the Linux Foundation project called SigStore. This tool is basically used for signing and verification of the container images. In cosign git page, if you scroll down, we can see the installation instruction. So as indicated here, for installing cosign, we need to have Golang installed in Ubuntu. And also the version should be above 1.16. So let's first check the Golang version in our Ubuntu. For that, you can use command go version. Right now, Golang is not installed in my virtual machine, so it did not display the version information as expected. Let's download the Golang then. For downloading Golang, go to the Golang website. And copy the link and again run the wget command. Sudo wget and paste the link. Downloading has started. Let it complete. Alright, so downloading done. Let's verify if the tar file which we downloaded is present under the local directory or not. So here it is. We can see the tar file available. Alright, so now let's extract this compressed GIF file in USR local directory. But before that, if you already have a Golang installed in your machine and it is of older version, then that has to be removed from the machine first. So Golang, so command for removing the older version of Golang and installing the new version will be, first let's remove the older version, sudo rm-rf, then directory path. This command will remove the older version. And then we have to extract this tar ball file. So let's just type sudo tar-c, then the path usr local, then the options xzf, then the file name. This is going to decompress the file in local directory, and it is done. Now let's add binary of Golang to the path environment variable and enable it. So let's just type export path equals the path variable and the binary path. Done. Now let's verify if Golang is installed. So let's type go version. Yep, got the result as expected. So the Golang version go 1.17.3 is installed on my Ubuntu machine currently. Now we are good to install the cosign. So let's just go back to the GitHub page of cosign and copy the command as mentioned there. This is the command, let's copy it. And paste it in our terminal. This installation is going to take some time, so I will be pausing the video and will resume once it is done. So meet you in the next section. So finally cosign is downloaded. It took around 20 to 25 minutes to complete the downloading process. Let's just clear the screen for the next steps. Cosign will be available under the go bin directory. So let's just verify it. Let's go to the go bin directory first and then type ls command. There we can see in the list cosync is available. Let's go back to installation instruction page now and follow the next steps. As the fourth step mentioned, after installing the cosign, next step is to validate the signature of the Sift CLI using cosign. So let's just copy paste this command on the terminal. It will take some time. It's done. As we can see, the result is verified OK. Let's follow the fifth step, which is to move the Sift CLI executable file to Sift directory, which will be created under local bin directory. Let's simply copy and paste this command as well in the terminal. Just paste it and press enter. Done. Let's assign read, write and execute writes over the Sift directory, which is in fact the fifth step of the installation process. So let's do it. Command is chmod 755 and the directory path. Oh, I forgot to use sudo command. So let's go back to the starting point and yeah, it's done. Now the requirement of installing Sift workstation is done and the only command left is to type sudo sift install. Once I will press the enter after this command, this will start the installation process and will take considerable amount of time to complete. I am again going to pause the video and I will resume it once the installation gets completed and Sift workstation is ready to be used. So let's just start the installation. So finally the installation is done. Sift workstation and its tools are installed over Ubuntu. It took almost 5 hours to complete. Let's reboot the machine so that all the installed upgrades can take their effect. Okay, let's give it some time to reboot. It is restarting now. Machine has restarted and we have login screen now. Let's simply log in with your Ubuntu credentials. It might take few minutes initially to log in. So we are into Sift workstation machine now. We can see we have Sift workstation terminal open by default. Let's just check the Sift version installed for verification. So just type Sift and version. So as you can see, I have version 2021.9.0 installed with desktop mode. So that is it guys, Sift workstation installed on my machine and hope it will be the same for you guys as well after following the steps as I have shown in the video. If you find this video helpful and informative, please like the video and subscribe the channel. I will be adding more videos related to the digital forensics and cybersecurity in the coming weeks. So thank you guys for watching and happy learning.